What's up, Southwest kids? I'm really busy right now because I'm preparing for a neighborhood potluck thing. So, yeah. To be totally honest, I don't know what's happening. My mom's just making me cook, so... She keeps telling me I'm a really good cook, but you be the judge. She keeps saying I need to use what I have to help others. I guess that's what we're learning about today. Stay tuned for more.
My mind was blown. I have no other words for it. And that is Avengers 13.
Producer, this guy's so weird. You're new. You're the new guy. Yeah, you're the new guy, right?
I've been here before. I said that last time.
Hey guys, we're rolling. We're rolling.
What is up, Southwest kids? Today, we are gonna be talking about compassion. And do you know what compassion is?
Do I know what compassion is? Well, compassion is caring enough to do something about someone else's need.
That is really good, and compassion actually goes along a lot with the verse Micah 6:8. But we're not gonna say it. We're gonna have you guys do it on your own because we've been doing it for a little bit because this is week 3. So, Micah 6:8.
Micah 6:8, the Lord has shown you what is good. He has told you what he requires of you. You must act with justice, and you must love to show mercy. You must be humble as you love in the sight of your God.
You guys did it like first try. That was like really good.
It's almost like they had it in front of them. It was crazy.
Yeah, oh my gosh, you guys are amazing. So now that you know what compassion is and the verse, we're gonna play a game.
What are we playing today?
I don't know. Producer?
I have a name, I have a family, I have feelings. You guys could be nice to me at some point of this month. Aren't we talking about compassion?
Yeah.
Whatever. Okay, in front of you guys, you have a few babies. Why don't y'all hold up your babies so the audience can see?
Ha! Mine has hair.
Dalton, yeah. You can put yours down, actually. That's terrifying.
Well, here's the thing. A baby was outside in the neighborhood playing some games, and it fell and got a boo-boo.
Continue.
Is it your turn to talk?
No, it's yours.
Okay, thank you. Your baby fell and got a boo-boo, and it needs to get all wrapped up. Your guys' responsibility is to wrap your baby, take care of it. The person who wrapped the baby best for the boo-boo is the winner. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
I think so. I can't think of any reason why we wouldn't hear it.
Yeah.
I've been preparing my whole life for this.
On your mark. Get set. Go.
These are mine.
Okay. Okay, so it depends really on where the injury was. Because he didn't specify.
Well, you gotta take it and you gotta go around. We don't have any needle and thread, so we can't do stitches right now. Baby, stay with me!
Well, I'm just gonna assume that it was a spinal cord injury, so I'm trying not to move the neck.
That would be why they can't move.
Oh my goodness, I'm such a genius. I remember. That's why I'm pretty confident about the girls' win. They've been doing pretty good, and I will admit, you did get one win for us when my refrigerator is running.
I did.
But, you know.
Did you catch your fridge, by the way?
I did. It does that kind of often, and it's been really annoying. I need to find someone to catch it, but.
Well, here's the thing. See, my baby has a fracture in its elbow. I need to fix that right now.
Are you qualified to do that?
Am I qualified to do that?
Mm-hmm.
Can a bumblebee dance?
I don't think so.
They can, actually. But I can't do this. I think so. Maybe. Maybe.
I don't know. The boys better hope, but we'll see.
So it needs to wrap around. So you need to wrap it around so that it's like a sling.
Oh. A broken collarbone, too?
No, not a broken collarbone. It's just you need to keep the arm above the heart. Yeah, I know. Very strange, but it's what we gotta do for right now. This baby is gonna look fine. It's just the embarrassment of right now is gonna make pay off later.
10 seconds.
Are you ready?
Hold your babies up.
She made it.
I do have to be honest. The only person who saved their baby was Dalton. Y'all didn't even check to make sure the baby was breathing. Jocelyn, your baby was not breathing.
Look at
Dalton,
her.
You saved your terrifying child. Bonus points for
covering her face
up. She's
gonna look far less terrifying after the bandages come off. The bandages are actually fixing it right now.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Most of this was plastic surgery. It wasn't actually like a big problem. Mm-hmm. She had that, but we fixed the face as well.
Oh, well, I think your compassion really saved her. Yeah. Being completely honest, I wouldn't say the same moment.
I know, so I just need she needs some bed rest and then maybe like a latte later. Yeah. Babies drink coffee, right?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I give mine like decaf, but I mean.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, I would think that this baby is gonna be okay. Hello, Southwest kids. Our next song coming up is I'm Following Jesus. Stay on your toes.
Say whatever, dude, we'll see how it goes. Now I don't know about you, I just know about me, and I know what to do. If I wanna be free, I'm following Jesus. Jesus, I'm following Jesus. Jesus. Down the road we go, it's really rather odd. We can play it safe and slow, or fly through life with God. I don't know about you, and everyone's going that way. I just wanna be free, so I'm gonna walk by faith. I'm following Jesus. Jesus, I'm following Jesus. I'm following Jesus, 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 Jesus. I'm following Jesus, Jesus. I'm following Jesus, Jesus. I'm following Jesus.
Southwest kids, it's Dalton here. I hope you've been having a wonderful week. And this week, our story is being brought to us by Miss Mary Pat. I hope that you have a wonderful time listening, but you better listen up. You might miss something.
Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to Kids Zone this morning. This morning, we're talking about compassion. And compassion is when you care about other people's needs. And as Christians, we should care about other people's needs and we should act upon that, care enough to do something about it. So this morning's story is a true story from the Bible, God's true word, and it's in John chapter 6. But before we get to that, I want to sort of set the stage. This is one of Jesus' coolest miracles. So most people think about the miracle, but it also really shows us about Jesus' compassion. So Jesus was traveling with his 12 friends, also called the disciples, and they traveled all around, and there were crowds that followed them everywhere because Jesus was doing miracles, performing miracles, and he was healing people. So the people wanted to come and hear him speak, hear him teach about God, and they hoped that they would see a miracle, or if they were sick, they wanted to be healed. So they followed him everywhere. So Jesus, at one point, he just needed a little quiet time. He needed a break. And so he told the disciples, we're going to cross the Sea of Galilee and go someplace where I can just have a little quiet time away from the crowds. So they get in a boat and they travel across the Sea of Galilee and they get to the other side and there's 5,000 people waiting for him. They have all walked ahead of him or gathered from other places and they're waiting for him on the other side. So here he wanted to go get some rest. He just needed some quiet alone time and there's 5,000 people. Now to give you an idea of how many that is, probably your school, if you put all the kids from all the grades together, like an assembly, if you've ever seen them all together, and then multiply it times 10. That's how many people are waiting for him. So it wasn't quite what he had hoped for, but Jesus loved them and he had compassion on them. So even though he was tired and he wanted to rest, instead he taught them. He had compassion on their need to hear him, and teached him to them. So he taught them and he taught for hours and they listened for hours. And by the end of the day, it had gotten late. They'd been listening and no one had brought any food. So they were really hungry. They didn't think anyone had food. They were hungry. Jesus could see they were hungry. The disciples could see they were hungry. So Jesus had compassion on them. He didn't say, well, they should have thought ahead and brought food. He just had compassion on them. He knew how he was going to feed the people. But before he told his disciples how he was going to do it, he asked them a question. And so this is where we're going to pick up our story in John chapter 6. Jesus turned to one of the disciples named Philip, and he said, Philip, where can we buy bread for all these people to eat? Philip's like, what? You know, we're out in the middle of nowhere. They're in the wilderness, and there's 5,000 people. And Philip answered him, suppose we were able to buy enough bread for each person to have just one bite. That would take more than half a year's pay. So he's like, that would take this much money and all this money. And there's like, no way we could feed all these people, right? But Jesus had a plan. Jesus had a plan. So if we continue on, another disciple said, well, here's a boy with 5 small loaves of barley bread and 2 small fish. But how far will that go to feed a big crowd? So he found a little boy who had his lunch with him and it had 2 fish in it, let's see if we can get the fish out, and 5 small loaves of bread. So he shows this to Jesus. So there were 2 fishies and 5 loaves of bread, because the boy had just thought about feeding himself for the whole day, not 5,000 people, right? But Jesus said, have everybody sit down. So he had 5,000 people sit down. They actually sat in groups. And he had them sit, and then he took the boy's lunch, and he prayed over it and he thanked God for providing the food. He gave thanks. And then he started handing out the bread. And he handed out the bread and he handed out the fish. And he kept reaching into the boy's lunch and more fish came out and more bread came out. And the disciples are passing it out and they're kind of not knowing what's going on. And pretty soon everyone had food. Everyone had enough to eat. It was crazy. They had fed them all from this little boy's lunch. And more than that, Jesus said at the end, now go around and gather up the extra food. And they're like, extra? We started with a boy's lunch. And they walked around and they collected 12 baskets of leftovers. 12 baskets. Some people think that there were 12 baskets so that every disciple came in with a basket. They each had one so that all 12 of them knew what an amazing miracle this was. So wow, the people started wondering, maybe this is the Savior that is supposed to come into the world and save us, God's Son. And that's another verse in John 6. They said, this must be the prophet who is supposed to come into the world. So they realized that Jesus was special, that this was a miracle from God, that he could feed 5,000 people with just 5 little loaves of bread and 2 fish. So Jesus cared deeply about every single person that was there. We think of it as this big mass crowd of 5,000 people, but Jesus cared about every single person. If you had been there, he would have cared about you. And he cared deeply enough to use one boy's lunch, one little boy's lunch, and he was able to feed everybody. He was able to meet everyone's need because he had compassion on them and he cared. So we all have things that we can share. We might think it's little, like the little boy probably thought, what can they do with my lunch? Look at all these people. But we all have something that we can use to meet other people's needs. And we just need to trust that God can work through us in amazing ways. He can do miracles. He can just work in our hearts to make us want to share with others. And that's the key bottom line for today, boys and girls, that God can work through you in amazing ways, and we need to use what we have to help others. We need to have compassion on others, love others, care about their needs, and use what we have. And it might not be physical things, tangible things like food. It might just be our time and our service to offer to mow someone's lawn or to see if you can do an errand for them or go buy them food at the grocery store. Even if you don't have the money, you can help an elderly person, for example. That's a great way to help others and to show love, because we were loved first by God, and that's what He wants us to do. So the bottom line, use what you have to help others. So let's pray right now and ask God to help us to do that. Lord, thank you for this story of the little boy and to show what an amazing miracle God did with two fish and five loaves of bread, Lord. Help us to remember to trust you, God, to trust you to make us just more compassionate and to use what we have as long as we open ourselves up and look to you, Lord, and trust you, Lord. Help us to love others, to show compassion, to care, and to take action. We ask you to help us in Jesus' name. Amen. Good job, boys and girls.
What's up, Southwest kids? Right now, we're about to sing a song called Walk on Water. And it might sound kind of weird if you don't know, but if you put it into perspective, in the Bible, Jesus did this really cool thing where he walked on water. I'll see you guys in there. Bye, guys.
I'd rather slip walking on water than spend my life wondering what if. Lord, if it's you, tell me to come. 'Cause you alone contain the wildest wind. I know I can make it, 'cause it was your voice that I heard. So I'm stepping out, I'm stepping out on your word. This is how you walk on water. One foot in front of the other. Never gonna let you go under. Just put one foot in front of the other.
Okay.
I got a faith deeper than feelings. 'Cause I know a name that's greater than this storm. I got a God who never ever fails me. Close enough to catch me if I fall. I know I can make it, 'cause it was your voice that I heard. So I'm stepping out on your word. This is how you walk on water. One foot,
come on, show it.
I'm stepping out on your word. I'm stepping out on your word. I'm stepping out on your word. I'm stepping out on your word.
I'm stepping out, stepping out, stepping out. I'm stepping out, stepping out, stepping out.
Walk.
Man, I learned so much today. I learned that it's important to help others. I can't wait to tell my neighbors, my family, and my friends all that I learned. Look at me using what I have to help others. See you next time, Southwest Kids.